Yeah, we talk about earthing and filtering. We're small tesla coils. I'm not going to go into the large tesla coils because they're a bit more specialised, and they're often used away from domestic properties. This is more to do with not interfering with your neighbours or causing any problems with them. This is my transformer box. It actually contains an old burner transformer, and when you look at the side, there's a standard IEC socket, or what looks to be a standard IEC socket. It is in fact a filtered IEC socket. Got it from another piece of equipment. Should be easy to identify. It's got a metal case instead of just being plastic. And on this one, the people who built the equipment decided to put another capacitor on the output. If you look at this diagram, you'll see that on the side of the connector is several capacitors. There's one across the input, two across the output, which are centered tapped to earth, and there's two inductors. Well, they're normally wound on a single ferrite toroid, and they help with the filtering. You can find other filters, they don't have to be IEC sockets, on old equipment. If you look very carefully where the mains comes in onto the PCB, for instance, you'll see a series of capacitors, and it'll look like either a transformer or a ring coil on the board. You want to try and get the same power of transformer filter as your transformer is going to be. This one is 11 kV at 18 milliamps, and that filter seems to do the trick. Just to go through how the connections are made, from the socket they actually go up to the switch at the front, which is a push button arrangement with a self-holding relay coil inside, and that's why I've got these two thin wires. These are for a dead man switch as such, but I haven't got to that stage yet. They only interrupt the coil, that's why they don't need to be very thick. From the main switch back to the transformer, you can see it going into the potting compound here, and the earth comes from the socket directly into the transformer, where it'll be earthed internally, and the two output terminals obviously. And just so you know, I do actually use car jump start leads for my these. I wouldn't go anything above 10-11 kV. I've had no problems with arcing between leads when using it on these voltages. Anything higher that you might find a problem. So that's to do with the filtering side. I did touch on earthing a little bit. Now if you look at this diagram, this is I can't remember exactly where I got this from, whether it was in the internet or what, but you'll see there that the mains earth goes to the transformer, whether it be an NST or an OBIT, and then if you decide you're going to put your tank circuit, which is your spark gap, and your capacitors in a metal box, then that would need to be earthed as well to mains earth. That's really, that protects the circuit and yourself from any dangers, any short circuits or anything. If you look at the secondary of the tesla coil, the bottom of that goes to what's known as an RF earth, or a radio frequency earth. The difference is that that one hopefully will go to somewhere solid in the ground. Ideally you'd run a wire to the outside. And this photograph is of my arrangement, where you'll see this what looks like three copper springs. Well, they're actually sockets that take the 4mm banana slugs. And there is the made, and I'll show you how to make them quickly. All you need is a piece of stiff copper wire. This is one strand of, I think, 10mm wire, but any copper wire that you can work with that will stay with the shape. That's a 4mm drill. I'm just using the shaft of it, and all you do is rub around. Give me a fairly neat, of course. This is very quick. And that leaves you two straight tails, which you can drill into the wood or whatever device you use to stick these into, and then you can solder these on the back to give you three or four sockets. My cables for the RF earth, I'm just using three core rubber insulated flex, just join all the three cores together for a banana plug on each end. This one is the more expensive type. That's another one where the case has got broken, and I've just soldered it all together and wrapped it with some tape. And the idea is that they just plug into the hole that you've made with the drill. So that would be my main RF cable from that socket you saw on the photograph up to the coil. Now I use the same things on the bottom of the tentacles for the RF earth, so it makes it very easy to plug them all together and change them around as I want. And even my earth rod has got the same plug on the end of it, and that plugs into one of the other connections in that block. I'll just show you the one of my coils. Okay, this is one of my coils. It's a bit dusty, it's been stood on the side. But that's the center coil, and what I normally do with my coils is put a base in the bottom with a bolt sticking out the bottom of it, and that bolt goes through the base, and then there's a ring, and I can put a nut on the bottom of that to make a good connection. The advantage of that is that if the coil moves about, it's not going to fall off and get broken. The earth wire, I'm not sure if you'll be able to see this, but I'll remove the secondary. There's the connection. It's drilled into the baseboard, and a piece of copper wire soldered on, and that then goes up underneath, and there's the loop which the bolt comes through. Like that, and then that just goes on there, then a nut is placed onto it. So, okay, the RF earth, that's your standard coil. As I say, I'm just doing tabletop coils. That's the bottom of the coil, which is your RF earth end, and then obviously the top, you've got your top load goes on there. So that connects to the bottom of the coil. And then from there, it goes through the cables and into a plug block. And that cable from the plug block then goes through the back of my kitchen units and to outside, where I've put a rod in the ground and connected to. So that is an RF earth. Now, I do understand that there's people out there that might be in rented accommodation, or they're in a flat where they're a couple of floors up, and it's not very easy to drop a cable out the window and put a rod in the ground, especially if the ground outside is concrete. So I think the only option for them is they can use the mains earth. For doing that, you can induce some current through the earthing wire back to the ground rod, and that can cause interference with other pieces of equipment in the house. Ideally, you should try and find a good strong earth connection. If you know where the earth wire goes out of the house or out of the flat by your meter, and you can get to it easily without causing any damage, you may find an earthing block that you can connect to. Just do it as a temporary basis. That will go more directly to the earth rod. If you use the plumbing or your central heating, you have to remember that any screwed fittings, and maybe some form of insulation like PTFE tape and this sort of thing, so there's a possibility you might not get the best earth, but it's better than nothing, I suppose. You sort of take a chance that the joints are good, they're all proper compression fittings, etc. Same with water pipes, especially if you've got old iron water pipes, they're usually screw fitting, and they've got PTFE tape or some equivalent in there as well. But as I say, if it's the best you have, then that's all you can do. But if possible, drop a wire out the window and connect it to an earth stake in the ground. That's the best form of RF earth. And a reasonable size cable to cover the current. It's only a small current, but if it's thick enough, then especially if you're more stranded, you'll reduce the interference to your neighbours or even to your own equipment. I think the only time I've had a problem with any of my coils was the bipolar. That hasn't got an RF earth because it's both ends come out to the top loads, and that was sat on this table close to my computer behind me, and it turned itself on, as you may have seen in the bipolar video. So hopefully that explains that you've got mains earth and an RF earth, and they should, if possible, be kept totally separate, and your RF earth goes directly to the ground, or as close as possible directly to the ground as you can. Your filtering, as I say, you can either get the IEC type filter already built in, you just fit it inside your transformer box or enclosure, or you might be able to find a filter on a board. If you look through the inside of the equipment, you'll see a couple of inductors in there. They may be wound in the same toroid, which is ideal, and there'll be a few capacitors around it. If you can preserve that circuit, then you'll be able to make yourself a small filter for your mains input.